Well, we're continuing to look for wisdom from Jesus on how to manage our sleep routines, and now we're looking at waking up in the morning. And it's such a critical part of our day and how we handle our bedroom, because what do we allow to shape and our thinking, our day? What is going to capture the focus of our attention right at the beginning of the day? Is it going to be social media, news, music, radio, or just our deceitful desires, or all our worries or anxieties for the day, the agenda for the day, the busyness for the day, our anxieties for the day, fear? All those things can crowd in on us as soon as we wake up. But Jesus in Psalm 5 shows us the correct way to take captive our thoughts and our focus as soon as we wake up. And it begins with, "Give ear to my words, O Lord, consider my meditation. Give heed to the voice of my cry, my King and my God, for to you I will pray. My voice you shall hear in the morning, O Lord. In the morning I will direct it to you, and I will look up." So you can see that this is all the way that Jesus would handle his days. And he wakes up and immediately wants to make his voice heard to his Father in heaven. It's get that focus straight. Check in, get that conversation going straight away as soon as we awake, and I will look up. So when he says in the Lord's Prayer, "Our Father in heaven," he means that. And it's so important that as soon as we wake up, we are capturing our true identity. Where do we belong? Who are we? Where does our security lie? Where does our hope lie? Because the psalm goes on, what is this meditation that he begins the day with? It's really this very clear rejection of lies and falsehood and the deceptions and corruption of this present age. Because all of that crowds in on us as soon as we get out into the day. So it's like, no, I'm going to begin the day by getting my heart and mind clear on reality. Truth, beauty, goodness comes from the Father, through the Son, in the power of the Spirit. And all these other voices and desires and appetites and agendas that are going to crowd in on me, no. And remind myself that this is the living God does not take pleasure in wickedness, as it says in verse 4. He hates all this evil. So if I'm going to direct my attention to him, I cannot love or tolerate all this evil and deception. I have to stand against that. I can't let it in, even by thinking about it or desiring it. No. Rather, my desire from verse 7 onwards is that I want to worship in your holy temple. I want to be caught up into that heavenly vision, angels and archangels and all the company of heaven. That's where reality is to be found. Lead me, Lord, in that way. And again, the meditation from verse 9 onwards. Not you, Lord, pronounce them guilty. I'm looking to you to form a correct judgment about all the world around me. And rather, where I want to get joy from, I want to be with those who find joy in you, the living God. That's where my joy, hope, peace, security needs to come from. So it's a tremendously important meditation at the beginning of the day. And as Richard Buse used to say, he would get up in the morning and say, "Another adventure with Jesus on planet Earth."